Hey guys, welcome back. Got Froden and Hyped on the sofa thing.
That's right. It's just a sofa.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
It's not a thing?
It's also, it could be a couch. You're right.
Okay.
So I guess, actually, you're right.
Yeah.
Sorry I questioned you, Crip.
Yeah. That's okay.
All right. Well,
so you're 2 stars from Legend. Yeah. We saw you playing there.
That's right. I was testing out the new, I guess Archon really made this aggressive Shaman deck, and It turns out it's pretty damn good, not only at making people mad, but winning games.
Yeah. Outfacing Face Hunter.
Outfacing Face Hunter. I'm racing.
That's all you need to know, guys.
That's crazy. A deck faster than Face Hunter.
It was designed to beat Druid, actually. So every card in their Firebrand was telling me is just good against Druid. You have like Mechanical Yeti.
Mm-hmm.
And just a ton of other things Druid can't deal with. Every time I played that game, I played that matchup twice. Twice against Zele as Druid. And I felt like it was about 0% chance to win. And I also watched Zixo beat Elesh with it. And he also had about 0% chance to win.
Okay. Yeah.
It's just like you can't deal with the Felreaver easily. And then if you hit face, it just does so much damage in general.
But Druid still run the one big game, right?
Yeah.
Isn't it? I'm not saying it's good, but isn't it greater than zero?
Yeah, of course. It's not like 100%. All the time. Like, everyone said, like, oh, Freeze Mage and Warrior 100% of the time, but we just saw...
Oh, I was rooting for the Freeze Mage.
It can happen, man.
Yeah.
Dreams can come true. It's harsh.
It can happen. Well, something's not happening for one of our...
For Gaara versus players. Tice. Yeah. I heard you predicted both these guys to get through, right?
Yeah, I thought they were going to be the finalists.
Oh, of the tournament.
And they can't be. Not both of them, at least.
They're the finalists. They're the finalists for the first eliminated in their group. So they can win that competition.
I was in that competition too. Thanks for clearing up.
And I won. I won that competition.
yeah. But I think out of these two players, the most disgruntled is probably Thice.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, because his Druid deck has done so well in literally every other tournament he's participated in, and with a conquest mode and having to play if you lose with the deck. Mm. Well, he 0-3'd with it.
This is an interesting debate that's been going on with some of the players. A few of them are very outspoken about Druid being pretty weak in Conquest overall.
Yeah, I was hearing that on the first day, and on the second day I was hearing
the opposite. Yeah, I mean, that's just opinion. Hype, where do you lean?
It's really hard not to draw Wild Go 3 games in a row, so it's pretty good.
Yeah.
You'll get a win with it eventually. But some people at this tournament are targeting Druid specifically. Reynad was trying to. Zixo made that Shaman to target Druid as well.
Yeah, so if you can snipe that Druid, pretty effective.
But I think it's a poor strategy.
It's always good to snipe a deck with a deck people haven't seen before. That's like the extra punish. Because you don't even know if it's bad, right?
Yeah, well, you're not even sure what's coming up next, exactly, because you don't know what to play the range out of. So it makes it even worse, even though it's already good against Druid. But Druid's not even anticipating some of the threats that are coming out.
And like, did you know that deck was going to be like 100% against Druid the first time you faced it? That's kind of what I mean.
Well, I did, since I was lucky enough to cast Zixo versus Elesh, I did know to keep Wrath, but it wasn't enough. Mm-hmm. That's like the only thing I did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Gotcha. Well, now we have an interesting set. This Shaman deck from Gaara isn't that aggressive mech. It's a more of a mid-rangey approach, and we thought mid-range Shaman was dead, Hyped, and I mean... You were even talking about it. I was like, nah, don't bring Shaman to this tournament. And Gaara did. Yeah. So what's up with that?
I'm guessing he's been talking to Gooby a lot about Shaman. And Gooby made a list like just the other day when there was only about 10 Legends on NA. Him and he gave it to like one of our contributors, Camps. And they both went straight to Legend with it. So it's like really good. And yeah, it's just solid mid-range deck. Nothing special about it.
But then what about like bringing Shaman with the specific lineup? He has Paladin and Priest with that. And it's like, well, you're asking to get destroyed by Rogue for one, but... I mean, if you can ban, I guess maybe it's not as bad.
Yeah. Gar just loves playing control versus control.
That's a strategy. He's greedy. And we're going to get to the first game of the series. It's Paladin versus Priest.
Yep.
I like this matchup, honestly. It's really fun.
I feel like for Priest, it's not that fun most of the time.
You think so?
It is really fun when you Thought Steal Aldor.
Yeah.
When you have a Cabal.
I guess if you have like really good Thought Steals.
Yeah.
Definitely, if the Paladin can ever reset and be in like a low card, low resource situation, the hero power runs away with the game.
Look at that hand on the Priest. Do you circle on the injured or do you circle on the Akanai? I think you circle on the Akanai.
Yeah, probably going to be forced to. We see the muster in the hand already. But Tice could just save it for later, maybe with
so
the
so many knives.
Right.
That is a 7 damage muster cast.
Yeah, and especially because there's 2 knife jugglers, you know, the injured blade mask doesn't do much. As the Priest player, all you have to do is play it similar to how you play against Shaman, collect insane value on a lot of your cards, But, I mean, Paladin's curving out pretty aggressively.
He's taking 13 damage on turn 3.
Is it 13 damage?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. I've never seen
that. The weapon hits for another one. Jeez.
That is absolutely crazy.
And
like, next turn with a good enough draw, you would be dead as the priest if you didn't have an answer here.
That's hilarious. Yeah, because, I mean, normally I think people are identifying that priest is favored against Paladin slightly. I mean, what do you think,
I think it's slightly unfavored.
I think it's slightly unfavored as well. But Thoughtsteal can change everything.
Thoughtsteals, good cabals. Mm-hmm. If it's a greedy priest, too, it definitely can scale. But the Paladin's so good at that tempo play.
Yeah, and they got a little stronger. And you see Tice is running two quartermasters, which most people are nowadays, which is really strong against priest.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's one of those plays that you need Light Bomb for. And sometimes Light Bomb is even a turn too late because you can't deal with the dudes right away. And you just take that buff hit before you can clear.
Can you just go on the offensive here? Because he's going to be at 10 health. Could you just press? I know Paladin's terrible at bursting, but...
Yeah, he's a little afraid of Shadow Man is probably with that play right there.
Yeah, fair enough. I mean, now it busts out to be a 4-5 Sludge Belcher.
That's pretty good, actually.
That's ridiculous.
And there's the Shadow Man.
Oh, man. So we always made comparisons when Sludge Belcher first came out to Sunwalker, but in the opposite order. And now it actually is like Sunwalker. Let me change. It's insane.
I think it's going with the Cabal. It's pretty nice because the Cabal gets a 5-5 and now kills the Sludge Belcher.
Yeah. Well.
That's another card that helps Paladin in this matchup, too.
Mm-hmm. For sure. Mm-hmm. And it puts Lay on Hands on turn 7 as well as makes everything else cheaper. So, yeah. This is, like, actually just snowballing out of control. Although, Priest does have some ways to
I like
to
keeping the
back.
4 health. I don't know if I like the trade here. I think maybe, if anything, I'd kill the 1-3.
Yeah, it's an easy collect on value here.
I just don't like sacking a 4-5 Death Rattle Taunt against the Priest.
What can go wrong on turn 7? It's not going to even be Cabald with the Shrinkmeister. So turn 7... yeah, I guess you're
Shadow Madness.
Safe.
That's really it.
Shrink Shadow Madness is also a possibility. It's still pretty hard to... to pass up killing this for pretty much nothing. Mm-hmm. 5 damage versus 4 damage is negligible because it already got the buff.
It's just if you're afraid of like a circle heal, like a full recovery on the 5-5 maybe.
Also a good point.
But with one plate, I think that was absolutely the best play.
Alright, well, mind control doesn't help for a while.
It actually does, though. If you see Tess has no like real threats in hand,
right?
He's probably just going to hero power, quartermaster, something like that.
We have to see the death here, I think.
Yeah, we first draw the card. Evaluate.
Would you? Get. What would you
yeah,
draw?
It's pretty much nothing.
You never know. Especially nothing for 4 mana.
Oh my
wow. God. Wow! Muzzle for Battle Quartermaster for 7 mana.
Hold on. But no, you can't do anything crazy. You can't muster double quarter. I wish you could. Kind of.
That's nuts.
I've never seen that.
5-5s.
I've never seen muster double quartermaster. Like, on the same turn.
It's still pretty crazy, because now you're threatening lethal possibilities. Like, if you draw, like, True Silver Champion. Holy cow.
That's still insane.
This is the fastest priest versus paladin I've seen in a long time.
Is there a clear here? Not that I see. You need another spell for it to be.
You can draw, but, like, if he draws, like, Circle of Healing, will that do anything?
Yeah, he can kill everything but one recruit. That'll keep him alive. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I guess we should draw first. Evaluate. Injured Blade Master doesn't help too much.
Yeah, not much to evaluate there.
No, sir. But still pretty decent. Controlling the state of the board. And that's the second muster for battle, right? So second quartermaster is effectively nulled. It's just a 2-5 to be stolen by a second Cabal, maybe.
He could have traded into the recruit, though, to play around the second quartermaster.
Oh, you're right.
I guess it's not too threatening here.
No.
I wonder.
I think I like killing the 5-2 more than anything.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to trade into it anyways.
And then kill off the Northshire to prevent the draws? Or the Pyromancer because it protects your board better.
Doesn't really.
Let me think.
If anything, it stops him from playing a spell or healing himself.
I don't know, though. Wouldn't you want to play the Harrison? And then you don't want to play Harrison into a...
into a Pyromancer, yeah. Just like a Thought Steal trade. That's pretty tough.
I think it's a slow enough turn that you can lay on hands.
Yeah, that's probably the best play, for sure. Mm.
You can even fit it in so that it heals for full value. So you attack first, then lay on hands.
You could even like eat Zombie Chow, too. So it's good.
Yeah. I do like denying the card engine draw, because that's one way Priest can run away with the game. Because if it can out-resource you, then it can corner you into playing Tyrion. It already has like the perfect answer to it. Like Shadow or Death to Harrison or Mind Control.
He just needs a crappy spell. Doesn't get it, though.
Yeah. And you can't.
One crappy spell would have done a lot there. Like if it was a Shadow Word Pain. If it was a Shadow Word Pain, it almost game over.
Yeah, or... was Second Shadow Menace dead? No. Still, though. I don't think he's dead.
The Second
right?
Shadow Menace would actually work, but you'd have to heal his minion.
Oh, you're right. That's funny.
I wonder.
So what's the play here? Just gonna trade and gain as much health as possible with Zombie Chow?
No. Oh, yeah, I guess.
Well, he has to make sure he doesn't die. So I guess that's the best course of action.
Holy cow, there's gonna be some buffed dudes.
Hmm. You know, Quartermaster's still getting some pretty sick value.
No, actually, I think I'd want that Sylvanas off the board.
Oh, so you're going to trade everything in? Then?
Yeah, you don't really lose much. Like, you basically lose a 1-1 for nothing. And you get a great trade on a Sylvanas.
Yeah, that's true.
That's basically as if Sylvanas was like a Boulder Fist, basically, in terms of value.
If you press for damage, how much is it this turn?
It's only 2 off lethal.
2 off lethal?
And it's not like... the priest can brawl, so there's a good chance something sticks, right?
Yeah.
No wonder.
Because there's 9, 10, 14, 16.
Actually,
you do have lay on hands,
no,
so
no. you can put him 3 off lethal and make it so Sylvanas can't kill itself by Argusing the buffed 1-1 and the quartermaster.
Right.
That's like a good compromise play.
Reporting for duty. Fair enough.
Okay, well, this is another compromise play.
It is. It gives him a little bit more aggression with the 4-2. And, well, there is a Shadow Madness.
I wonder.
Doesn't really... Let's see. There's a lot of ways to play this.
Yeah, you could protect the Sylvanas. Keep the Sylvanas healthy.
Right.
Shrinkmeister the... Wait. Nope. Yeah, Shrinkmeister the Harrison. Run it into the recruit. Mm-hmm. And then the Sylvanas is alive.
I think that might be the bigger priority here. Because you're still at 8 health. And I don't think Paladin can do it without Ragnaros. So... I guess I don't really mind that. The priority here is to clear the board. If he uses that, he also can put out the injured Blade Master, but it might be better to heal.
I'm thinking of some pyro plays. Is there like something really wacky here? Yeah, there is.
Yeah.
You can steal Harrison. You can attack Sylvanas into the 4-2, and then Shadow Madness the Defender of Argus.
Yeah, but then don't you want to keep Sylvanas on the board? As much
as it's
cool to steal. You want to make sure to try.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
Oh, I like this too because it puts it keeps the most power on board because you know that it's going to be unlikely he has consecration.
Yeah, now that I say this is way better than anything we talked about.
No worries. I see. Oh, how much damage is he off? 3. Oh, actually, he can't attack twice. Never mind.
No, he's 3 off lethal again.
Yeah. Well, the nice thing is that Lay on Hands is a really big deal because you can keep up in the card count here.
Yeah.
So if he went all face on the Sylvanas turn, he would have just won here.
Right. But is that the play that wins the games most of the time?
Oh, he could have gone with Crypt's play as well and just put him one off lethal. Same situation.
Well, he picks up the Owl for the Sylvanas.
No, I don't think it's required.
No, yeah. Well, eventually, he might want to use it. Let me best just to play Aldor.
You can't Aldor Sylvanas. If you want Aldor Sylvanas, you have to silence it first. Mm-hmm. I really liked True Silvering Sylvanas, actually. Because then, like, the priest just doesn't do much damage. And then you can kill the next thing with True Silver, or you can lay on hands and then try to get a Consecrate. Like, I think if you're going to give up the aggression game, you should have killed Sylvanas with True Silver.
Ooh, Thought Steal could be really big. Meh.
That's okay.
Yeah.
You can deal with the next Muster Quartermaster. Oh, there isn't one, right? There's no more Musters. Well, you can deal with a few recruits.
Actually, Pyromancer with Consecration deals with...
I'm saying there's no more Muster, but once eventually he'll Hero Power, right. Quartermaster.
Oh, that. I don't know about that.
Playing around True Silver Champion for an easy kill.
Yeah, you always want to keep stuff at 5 against Paladin.
Yeah, but at 10 health.
Well, what is Paladin going to do?
He sees the Consecrate right there, so he knows like that's not part of his burst, although he did just draw it. But usually you're thinking about True Silver Consecrate is the most burst they can do.
Mm-hmm. That's fair. Well, man.
All the Paladin plays just suck.
Yeah.
From this
pretty
point.
Terrible. They're all so situational.
God.
Doesn't Gara play Dr. Boom in his priest deck?
I'm not sure.
I feel like he does. And so it's
it was Ignite that did.
Oh, you're
that
right.
A
I think
point of. He might. I mean, chances are probably likely that Dr. Boom is in there.
Because Gara's so greedy.
Yeah, but I think we made an emphasis on Ignites.
Right.
No, just because it's Dr. Boom.
Why not?
Here's how you make a deck in Hearthstone. You choose the class and you choose Dr. Boom. And then the next 29 cards
optional.
And you
play Big Game Hunter for their Dr. Boom.
Oh, yes.
That's right. So it's two cards. Two core cards.
Mm-hmm.
Would you just... Well, okay. Actually, you can't even choose Silver Push here for a win because the priest can keep healing. And Light of the Nari would destroy you, too. Oh, man. Let's see. That Northshire Cleric might allow him to just start drawing cards and running away with the game.
Thing is, the priest also has trouble finishing. And if you draw too many cards, you might just kill yourself.
True. Although there are 12 cards away, so still some time.
Yeah.
Man, this is really good for Gara. And then he heals up Sylvanas back up to 5. Oh my goodness, everything is just so problematic for Paladin.
That's cool.
Recombobulator.
I mean, if you really give up on your Sylvanas, you can just try again.
Yeah.
Yeah, just unsilence it, take the Aldor off.
Create Sylvanas again. Is that the wildest 6 drop? No. There has to be This is where we ask Amaz, because Amaz has all the Recombobulator.
Emperor.
Oh yeah, you get the Emperor for a cheaper mind control.
Big.
Unnerf mind control back to 8 mana.
No, there has to be a better 6 drop.
Sky Golem's pretty good against Paladin.
What about Mogar?
Mogar the Ogre.
Yep.
It's just like a 7-6, right?
It gets straight BGH, though.
Oh, it does get BGH.
I think you'd want the Sky Golem.
What about High Mane? Just go ham.
Yeah.
Be sick. Well, man, all these options are awful. I think denying the card draw, though, is definitely a priority here.
Yeah.
Northshire's too dangerous. Just cycle. The Acolyte is like a worse loot hoarder. Reporting for duty. And Power Word Shield. Nah. allows him to dig deeper. This matchup's going really slow. It's like it was really fast because the Paladin almost had an opportunity to go for blood.
Yeah.
And now it's like at a
But the Arcanine Circle just changed it up completely. Yeah. And yeah, I mean, it really came down to Tice's unwillingness to really push aggressively.
It doesn't feel like his play style, right? Tice is generally more conservative than...
I don't even know if I've seen him play Paladin before, honestly.
He's played in a couple of recent tournaments. It's generally new tech. I know that, like, Nihilim's really been pushing for small innovations within common classes, like Druid with Nourish and Ragnaros, and then Paladin with Sky Golems, like Life Coach, and of course the Sky Golems and Mech Mage. Like, that's definitely the Nihilim special.
I went for the zap on the rocket.
He did. People can't see, but Krip actually played that rocket launch perfectly. He needed precisely those two clicks to launch.
That's going to miss.
Lothar.
No.
No. Lothar tried to go for it.
I just make it look easy, don't worry. It's actually really hard.
Let me think. Oh, he's playing around a quality. Nice. That is definitely the combination here to shut it down. And now if you're Paladin, hopefully you can start building up a small army of 1-1s.
Yeah,
even though you don't have...
It's the dudes that are really crushing. Like, once there's like three, it starts becoming a problem.
Oh, he's going to try to see if he can do a lethal push with Big Game Hunter in 2 turns.
That seems insane.
Yeah, but if there's no boom...
Right.
What else are you going to do with it?
How do you know there's no boom?
Oh, was he not able to watch the... I mean, Garwin
maybe
pretty
he saw
long.
The games.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Gar actually went to zero.
Right?
Yeah, right. So you know for sure if there was a boomer.
Wasn't one of the casters mentioning that Tice was writing down all the cards?
I think it's quite expected.
Maybe. I think Artosis was saying about that.
I wonder.
I think you can afford to play a little bit slow. But I guess the Big Game Hunter does accelerate to like a 3-turn kill.
The thing is, the True Silver hit's really good because... It makes the Light Warden
pay
a lot.
Yeah.
It's still a pretty good Light Warden, though.
And getting that health up is actually really big, too, because he's only played one True Silver, right?
Yeah.
So now he'll be out of range for the second True Silver.
Do you Holy Nova? I think you do.
Yeah, controlling the board state is much more important, just because the army of 1-1s shouldn't ever be able to build up if you get the Light Warden. Funny enough, like Alder Peacekeeper is designed to initially keep attack low, but it can't control the Light Warden for long.
The Owl can, though.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're right. And his opponent already played Sylvanas, so you're not really saving Owl for much.
I think you actually play both of those cards. You should play every
really,
card in your hand.
It's a pretty good
turn.
Card against Priest.
Yeah. Teach that Light Warden a lesson.
Oh, is he not? He's not playing the Aldor? No, he's not.
Does he want to... Okay, well, one, it collects value, but two, it also makes...
Ooh.
Just because I know that he knows Gaara has a mind control, so it could be one of those things where he really wants to force his opponent to have to use it when he's in a tough spot, and then he could try to play that card. So it might be one of these things where he has to fight really resource-intensive. Well, that's all right. It's just out of the range of Cabal Shadow Priest. So force him to take the 2-1 instead. Well, boys, this is the scenario we're talking about. If Paladin can stabilize, it'll run away. Ah, that's a bad draw.
Like, there's worse draws than that. Anything big is a bad draw at this point. Because it makes the mind control
hit.
That's
a fair point.
So he really just needs, like, mid-game stuff and... I think he's played most of that already. I don't think they are good draws.
Yeah, I guess fair enough. The nice thing is that it didn't get stolen by Cabal.
Yeah, if anything, the priest drawn badly is more significant than, well, he just did.
Mm-hmm. And now it's the point of can he stop the march of the 1-1s in time? All cards have been played, too.
Yeah, what is Gar looking to draw here?
Well, next turns?
Yeah, we probably recombobulator for that Cabal.
I guess Thought Steals. There you go, Lothar. Second time's a charm.
No, that was Hype.
No, that was Zoltar.
Hype. Nice job, man. Yeah. Show how it's done. Zoltar's very offended. All right, well,
that's a
Paladin
good,
needs to draw. Chili Minibot's actually good pressure.
It's just slowly being too annoying to deal with.
Yeah, the Divine Shields are actually very problematic. And I think that's the second Cabal, right?
I actually think he has to use Mind Control on a shielded Minibot.
Thought Steal could change that, though.
It could brick the game, though.
Dr. Boom?
Yeah.
So if he kills off the Puddle Stomper and his opponent draws Chew Silver or Consecration number 2. Oh, no, he already used 2 Consecrates, right? He's just missing a few points. Oh, man.
Oh, man.
If he plays that, he's dead.
Yeah, if he plays it, he's locked out. Unless he goes for face damage and his opponent mind controls his entire turn, and then you have Consecrate to push through or some kind of direct damage.
Consecrate.
Yeah, he used all of it, right?
I mean, Gaara has 5 cards left. Tice has to know.
Right. That mind control is highly likely.
Certain.
Almost certainly.
It is certain. Like, the Paladin doesn't have many cards either. The Paladin has 5 cards. He's got True Silver. So, like, even if he...
Wow.
Even if he loses the board, he'll probably kill him with True Silver.
True.
But if he plays Tyrion and he gets mind controlled, he has no chance.
How many turns does he have to try and push this through? What if Boombots have the worst outcomes?
Boombots RNG basically dictate that.
Yeah. Mm. 1 damage off lethal. I must move quickly. Does Gaara have a second Holy Nova?
I want to see the light bomb. The rip in peace Dr. Boom light bomb.
Man. Sludge Belcher. That's insane. Whoa.
Top dicked. No.
Wow. I mean, I don't think that Paladin can do anything
about
that.
The shield with the bot is
the
best.
Yeah, you definitely throw it into the bot. More targets.
Yeah.
You know both Quartermasters are down.
Yeah, pretty much almost.
Unless he wants to go face with the boom. But no, he doesn't want to.
Yeah, there's no need to because you know you can lock your opponent out. Oh, to the face. Oh.
Wow.
Wow.
That was horrifying.
Boombot to the face and not even killing a shield of the mini
bot. I think a True Silver actually seals it this turn.
But yeah, if you put the bomb into the shield, then you can put the boom into the full health.
Mini-bot. Oh, you're right. That's actually true. Yeah, you're absolutely right, Hyped. There was definitely a way to guarantee it. And he would have taken the same damage either way on the boom.
Oh, man. You have to play something.
Yeah, and...
You can't pass here, because if you pass, you will certainly lose. Here's at the point where you have to take a risk. So do you want to go full risk or just partly risk?
So if you play Sylvanas and he steals it, then...
There's no way... Oh, go ahead.
Well, yeah, so if you play Tyrion, he still has a chance where he steals the wrong thing, right?
Yeah.
So that's still the better option here. Plus, you get to build your board.
Oh, no, I'm thinking if you play Tyrion and then Sylvanas to take Tyrion back.
Yeah, but Paladin has no way to... It would take a full turn.
Right. Yeah. And you're also taking Dr. Boom damage, assuming he's pushing. Yeah, this is... you have to keep your targets as high as possible because you're assuming this is getting stolen, right?
No, you need to keep as many targets as possible so you can
right, so you don't
play
want to
Tyrion.
Yeah. Second Sludge Belcher. Wow.
It's pretty ridiculous. I think you just go face. I think you mind control Sylvanas, go face. Because you have Shadow Ward Death for the Tyrion.
But what about the True Silver draw to kill?
It's not enough.
Is it not enough? It would be lethal, I believe, if he did that. Because he would have exactly 3 to pull.
Yeah.
Okay, so he just plays it extra safe, I believe.
Must consider.
Although, yeah,
Consecration number 2? Or that he's already used 2.
Yeah, he already used 2 Consecrates. So Tyrion comes down. And
Lose.
Is it Tyrion into lose? Because Lothab is certain death, so he's got to do this. Yep. And Shadow Word Death just pushes through, and that's going to be game. So, what a pretty tight contested one. But Priest ends up weathering the storm here. Oh, I like it. Recombobulator the Dr. Boom. Do it.
No, he probably doesn't want to show. Oh, yeah, he doesn't.
He already knows. This is what had to happen. He recombobulated that into Baron-Geddon and attacked with the one slime and the turn, and he lives with one health and kills his opponent.
Mm.
That's the ultimate BM.
Do you
approve of that, Crip?
Gero's just thrown his RNG out the window.
Yeah,
you have to appease the BM gods.
That's true. He didn't make a sacrifice.
Yeah.
All right, so game one's in the books, guys. And Tice, he could be.
Tice has not won a game at this tournament yet.
On stream. Right? Didn't he win his off stream games?
No, this is his loser's match.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Tice could be swept out here, and that'd be really bad. Like, just for his own. Because I know Tice, for example, he's like a player that people like respect a lot, but he also puts the most pressure on himself to succeed.
Yeah.
Because the rest of his team,
his results are really good. That definitely is represented.
But recently, in the past month, he's been saying he hasn't been doing well at all. He's been losing almost like first round of everything. Mm. So he's like really needed to get back onto the train. And he's like, he jokes that maybe RDU's streak has rubbed off on him because RDU's starting to pick up results again. He got second in two tournaments, he got second and he won a tournament recently. And then Tice has been exiting out.
All right. So it looks like it's Paladin versus Mage. It's going to take a second to get to the other cards up as we're having an issue with the spectate mode again.
We see double Zombie Chow Mind Control Tech in Gar's deck, so you can be sure there's some heavy, heavy cards in there, like maybe Kel'Thuzad, Ysera, Rag, stuff like that.
Yeah, Gar is definitely one of those guys that really likes to be super greedy and then just like make his beginning and his end really heavy on controlling the board.
I'll show them all!
Mad Scientist. Well...
Oh, we haven't seen the mage, have we? No.
No, but this this mage is a mech mage.
Mm-hmm.
Almost certain that's going to be very similar to what Nihilim likes to run with the pilot sky golems. Lothar doesn't show any reaction, though. Oh, he's laughing. All right. There's the sky golem in this deck. I want to play poker with you later, Lothar. Are we feeling lucky? Oh, my.
Almost.
Would he want to save a zombie chow for a mirror entity?
Yeah, he's probably thinking about it a lot.
No, if the first dagger missed, I think you'd trade. But if the first dagger hit, then you have to go for it.
Right. So, well, I was thinking, wouldn't you want to save a zombie chow in general for mirror entity?
No, I actually think that was the worst RNG possible. Because if the first dagger missed, then you trade, then you give him a zombie. But if the first dagger hit, you have to go for it. And then if the second dagger fails, then you can't attack.
Oh, if you kill out the Mad Scientist with the second summon Zombie Chow, it automatically mirror enemies.
Right.
Oh, wow. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. So that was the worst possible energy for Gera.
Oh, well. Hype's being summoned away by the Salt King himself right now. So it's just me and Crip.
Okay.
Oh, Hype's disrobing. Oh, stream is missing out, man.
Wow, that's a very nice Tempo Storm jersey that you have under your Need for Seat.
Thank you.
Is that what you're paying? I was paying attention to what was underneath the Tempo Storm jersey.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
What to do?
Well.
What to do?
Mech Warper number two. That makes everything, right? Play everything? Yeah. Oh, you can't play the Mad Scientist.
You wouldn't want to.
Yeah. There's another secret already out. And now it's going to be on Consecration, right? To try and control the state of the board.
No, MC Tech does a good job. If you take the Shredder, you're actually instantly ahead.
Is there a chance to steal the MC Tech? Right? Because it comes out first or no? Oh, no, Battle Cries?
Oh, that's so funny.
No,
wait, right.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't? Okay.
No.
So the Battle Cry activates first, so it steals a minion and then it gets copied.
Yes.
So stealing the Pilot Shredder would be so big here.
Oh, yeah. Actually, stealing a Mech Warper is good, too.
Oh, my goodness.
No. Just the worst thing would have been the Chugga-Chugga, because if it was a Mech Warper, then you can continue tempo with the Shielded Minibot.
That's so funny. You're right. He's got mechs in his deck,
So there's only one really bad outcome there.
Ah,
but he's
yeah.
still got the best.
Wow, this is hilarious. Look at this board state.
I think you just want to remove power. Like, at this stage, the Mech Mage has no cards. So you just want to kill that Mind Control tech, I think.
If you kill off a Mech Warper, he still can summon the most expensive mech in his deck, which is the Sky Golem for 5.
Yeah.
So I think it's inconsequential. If you kill off the Snow Chugger, it does enable a True Silver top deck.
I don't think you actually even need a True Silver top deck right now.
I mean, would you not play it if you drew it next turn, I guess?
I really think the Mind Control tech has to die. Just the 3/2 attack
that's
creatures
true.
Is so bad.
Yeah.
Like, that's one thing you always pay attention to in Arena. It's not really a factor in Constructed because there's bigger things.
Yeah.
But in this game, there really aren't.
Man.
Yeah, it's that having all your creatures do the same damage is really poor when you're fighting for the board.
Yeah. Awkward trades.
Yeah, very, very bad trades.
So he's just going to try to force his opponent to have some kind of removal.
I think here you actually... you kill off the Zombie Chow and ping off the 3/3 while going face. Yeah. Ping in the 3.
Yeah, and force him to make the trade.
Yeah.
I like it. Squeezing in damage.
You're desperate enough that you have to do this.
I was thinking about the Pilot Shredder, though.
Oh, this could be a disaster. Is he killing it?
Trading it? No, he has to go face, right? Yeah. Ooh, Cockhammer's interesting, too. Because it can kill off the Snow Chugger without getting frozen. And that was like, that's like huge, so that way he can attack with it next turn.
Wow.
That's funny.
Now that's he can play, cool.
It doesn't do anything, right?
Yeah,
it's
I
only
guess
the first
right.
one. Yeah.
Oh, you're right. Because he can't play both Mech Warp or Shielded Mini Bots.
And there's that Pilot Sky Golem. And actually, that kill on the Mech Warper was very significant because otherwise he would have had the mana to ping off the shield, which he no longer does.
But he does cash in for a Mirror Entity now.
Yeah.
And try to make it really awkward. But there is a way to make it also awkward for your opponent. Although he can't deal with the Pilot Sky Golem easily.
No,
it's going to cost
him. I like
him.
The big game. You yeah, trade with a Divine Shield. You finish off the Mech Warper. Yeah, you're taking some damage, but you have that's what Lay on Hands is for. You're going to lose a little bit.
Sounds fair to me. So then we're basically on Dr. Boom, right? Like, Dr. Boom's got to really pull the Mech Mage back in here. Man, BGH trades so well into this Sky Golem, too.
Pinging off that shield is really important.
What's the dude that does 6 damage to your face? The demon.
Pit Lord. Oh, you're right. Well.
Pit Lord isn't a thing anymore.
Pit Lord is not that much of a threat.
I can clear the mechs completely.
And he has Lay on Hands to kind of get himself out of that burst range. Huh.
Now he can lose to Pit Lord.
Yeah, now he could do it because he did it before the body, so that way he can keep his board presence as high as possible. I guess he's just hoping his opponent doesn't pick up Blast Mage or something and completely wreck him. So assuming he's not trading everything in and then another mech
pops out. It really
depends
on just what comes out.
Yeah.
That's really the factor here.
Well, that's what I originally thought he was going to do that instead.
Tinkertown.
Technician gets a spare part.
Swap would be decent.
Slightly punished, yeah, for Aldoring the first half.
Right. Yeah, I suppose you could use it. Or you could save it for the chance that you have Antonitis. You need some spells for it.
All right.
Oh, he plays Guardian of Kings as well.
That's so much healing. I don't think there's any way the Mech Mage can actually do this.
Yeah, now that's like, how do you do? Unless something huge comes out of that Pilot Sky Golem.
Whoa. Something huge came off the top. The Boomster.
Okay. Yeah, now he's can start picking apart the board. And these Boombots can have such big impact. I mean, they can kill the Guardian of Kings single-handedly.
Actually, a Boombot can trade with Guardian of Kings and Hero Power.
That's so funny.
One of my favorite Sky Golem interactions is Baron Rivendare Boombots.
Oh,
I hope
God.
We get to see it. Oh, my God.
Let's yeah, that would be crazy. Whoa.
Just 16 right to the face.
Oh, it's Pit Lord.
you got to respect Pit Lord.
Oh,
that's what you
man.
Got Aldo.
Nah, he's going to have to be an Argus Harrison play.
Yeah, and then kill off the Pit Lord. So that way you have a better trade.
Goblin Blast Mage
wow.
is pretty nasty.
The RNG here can swing this game entirely.
Where is it going to land?
Holy
wow.
cow.
Straight into the taunted minions.
I don't even know what to think of that.
He just has to hit one of the big ones.
Yeah,
wait.
These Boombots have to have high impact. If they miss the
Why
Guardian
is it
King
first.
Yeah.
Shouldn't he ping second? Okay.
It's going to hit
anyway.
That was wrong, right?
Yeah, you know
I don't
what?
Know. It looked right to me.
I think you throw the bomb in. That way there's two good targets.
But of course,
and then you
course.
Ping the one, yeah.
We're just messing with...
He needs a quality, right?
Like play bad, get good RNG type of play. But, you know.
Well, yeah, Gaara got punished because Gaara
gets a quality
the thing, and then. Yeah.
So he's got a board. Well, I guess the Boombot survives. But
here
dang, if it's
the
not close,
fireball.
It ain't fun.
Running fireball. Here we go.
Oh man.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Close enough. Antonitis comes down, and now how does Gaara deal with this?
Just spam threaten.
Yeah, but that doesn't actually deal with it. Just helps
okay.
you cope.
Okay.
Well, I mean, if he just keeps hitting minions, I guess Antonitis is just a body. So there's
no,
that. There's that
it's
possibility.
It's gonna be a fireball. I'm sorry. There you go.
Oh, that's lethal.
That's way lethal.
Frostbolt to end the game.
That's somehow, some way. So much lethal, you can even like get rid of Tyrion and kill him.
Yeah, you're right. Hey, you gotta toss in the Boombot, man, for good measure. Yeah. All right. Well, that wraps up game number two in the Tide series.
I do want to mention that Gaara was punished because of his failure to appease the Recombobulator,
right.
and the BM gods.
Well, also the
and now, and now Thais has done the same thing. So now we're back to square one.
Is that really true, though? I'm pretty sure if you appease the BM gods a bunch, they just punish you with putting you one damage off lethal frequently, is what I've heard.
Is it? I don't know. Are you BM often? Because I feel like you're
not. I do not BM often.
Exactly. Okay. And you're often like one damage off.
So. Not as much as Forsen, though. So.
Yeah, but you have your fair share. You're a rogue player. I mean, you know, Gaara is actually really pissed. Even though right now he's like super calm, it's like he tilts really hard internally with like stuff like that happening.
It's a 1-1 right now.
Well, the way everything happened, he was pretty far ahead, and then looks like he was going to stabilize, and then that Pit Lord came out.
I mean, there was such a low chance the mage could come back in that game, and then it was ridiculous piloted Sky Golem into ridiculous piloted Sky Golem RNG. Into Dr. Boom, into ridiculous Dr. Boom RNG.
Into Antonitis.
Into Antonitis.
Into spell.
Into ridiculous spell top deck RNG.
Yeah.
Yeah, he didn't have to. We really didn't like him leaving that Sky Golem alive. He didn't have to leave it alive.
Yeah.
He didn't. And he could have also dealt with the second half of it with saving the Aldor as well. Mm. There was definitely things in the control of Gaara. But, man, that run was pretty sick.
It was pretty sick.
Yeah.
Like, I don't even know if it was good sick. It was just like, man, I don't know how to
like,
feel
it's
right
like
now.
It's like sickening.
Yeah,
that's
sickening.
What it is. It's not even like the cool kind of sick. That was nasty. And we're going to go to game number three.
Pally. These paladins can't do it.
Yeah.
Paladins have not
has
won.
A slower paladin, though, so I'm going to give it to him for sure. We didn't even see like the high drops yet. We just saw the guardian. There has to be nine drops. Or Kel'Thas.
Has to be like Ysera, Kel'Thas
on Ysera.
Right? Yeah, KT and Ysera seems to be his poison of choice. Although he does run that in Druid as well. Hmm. So Tice's Mech Mage is out, which means he's got Paladin and Druid remaining. And Gaara, of course, has his own Paladin and Druid.
Wow, both players are pretty good hands.
Yeah.
I think I prefer Gaara's, though. I usually like the True Silver better, but not this time.
Yeah, True Silver can be really important to get value, but you know, ever since Shielded Mini Boss started entering the fray, it's a little bit awkward to deal with everything. Mustard for battle is usually really key, too.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
All right.
Do you coin out the zombie chow?
Yeah, there's so many ways to kill off that... Or so many ways to deal with shielded mini-bot. Like, if you just musters for battle, you can just get blown out with the board at the moment. Yeah. You have to rely on Consecration to bring you back.
Yeah, you're right. But, like, if you do only the zombie chow or only the shielded mini-bot, you could lose just to the board.
You're right.
Like, badly.
What about just hero power and then coin true silver next turn?
Yeah.
I guess shielded mini-bot accomplishes almost the same thing, but... On the off chance he gets some bad juggles.
KT.
I think Tice realizes that he has the more aggressive build, especially with the Lotheb. So he knows he has to like do something to gain tempo back. I don't think.
Now let's talk about that KT. There's a foil. There's a golden KT respawn minions golden.
It does.
Really?
Yeah, we saw it earlier. He played a druid, and what happened was I think he killed off his big game hunter, and it came back golden. As well as he killed off like Azure Drake, and it was golden too. It was awesome. That's one way to make an all-golden deck, too, I guess.
The coin, if it's in your hand, it just turns golden once it realizes that one card you're missing gets turned golden.
That's cool.
Yeah. That's a fact.
If you were given any color...
No way.
If you were given any color of a coin, what color would you pick, Heights?
Do you have one?
No, because I'm not really that creative.
This golden is pretty good.
I like the disco ball. You know, it just shines through.
Oh, that'd be sick. Having a disco ball. We're reaching for topics here because this start has been pretty slow.
Actually, it's been pretty fast.
For just Paladin versus
played
Paladin?
It kind of slowly, yeah.
No, that's what I meant. Like, it's played slowly. The True Silver, though, seems to be his best course of option, like you were talking about, Hyped.
Consecrate seems about as good to me. Yeah. I think I'm okay with that.
Fair enough. Just I always feel like Consecration.
Hey, look,
you
want to
delay
Henry
using
like,
it because
what are you doing with a hand?
The thing about Consecration is that it isn't like how do you fight against a board that has Muster for Battle without Consecration? I guess maybe you can't worry about that too much. I'm not a Paladin versus Paladin expert hyped. Are you by any chance?
I wasn't paying attention because I was worried about the tarp, and that's what I'd have my coin as, Zebra Print.
Ah, that's good, man. The zebra print.
I think that would just get old. Like, you can't make foil zebra stripes. What if they were, like, foil zebra stripes and, like, the black parts had, like, see-through cool stuff like disco balls?
Oh, what about, like, optical illusions in the coin? That'd be sick.
What if it was just see-through? You could just see behind the board for the zebra stripes.
Okay.
That'd be cool. Or, yeah, the coin. So the blue part in the middle should just be see-through. So whatever's behind it, you can just drag it around. Put it over the coconuts.
I think we've come
to
understand.
Like Magic 8-Ball status. Yep. You can, like, shake the coin. It tells you your RNG.
Okay.
Like, you click the coin a bunch of times, and it's like, it'll tell you how the RNG outcome will be.
You know what's really funny? Right now, I think Thice is winning the control game.
Yeah, you know, that Acolyte's really problematic, actually. It's going to draw him cards.
So Gar doesn't have the Sky Golem, so what exactly is he rezzing with the Kel'Thuzad?
Well, he's got Sylvanas. Belchers.
A board that he won't have on turn 8.
Oh, it looks like the Sylvanas isn't going to work.
No, he's got the Iron Beak Owl. Although, if Sylvanas survives long enough, then KT...
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, KT revives.
That's the untalented mechanic everyone wanted.
Yeah. Unpolymorph. Zombie Chow... Pretty weak draw. I have no time for games.
You like that? I like killing the Acolyte there.
Just so that forces him to trade in, because he's going to do it anyways. And then, otherwise the Sylvanas would have been easy to take care of.
I think all this says is Gara feels really confident going as long as he doesn't get out of tempo here.
Yeah, the damage is pretty negligible. It's all about that board.
Man, I'm seeing more and more pizza boxes around here.
Is it making you hungry?
I'm a little hungry.
Go for it, man.
Quip was telling me about this vegan pizza with potato cheese.
Yeah.
It sounded like the grossest thing I've ever heard.
Oh, come on.
Potato cheese?
It's like mashed potatoes, like baking mashed potatoes.
All right. Oh, it's mashed potatoes. It's just because I don't really think cheese comes out of potatoes.
No, it comes out of cows.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we're going to need some fact checking here.
Well, you can make cheese out of almost anything.
Yeah.
Someone made human cheese once. Mm.
Is that vegan?
Probably more than once.
Is that vegan?
I don't know how vegan works.
Oh, my God. All right. So now the True Silver can test the Guardian of Kings pretty easily. This has been... with the Iron Beak Owl, it's actually quite awkward here for Gaara.
You have to play it, though.
Yeah.
Are we going to see the loner Kel'Thuzad, or does he need... Okay, it looks like he wants value. He wants to res his Guardian Kings, I guess, at some point.
Yeah, he wants to encourage his opponent to at least weaken the board so that way Consecration could be better, or he can get better value off his Guardian Kings. And over in Tyson Lane, he picks up the second choose over, which makes it a little bit easier. So he can prepare against anything, and now he's got some pretty decent options. Build the board slightly, play Pilot Shredder, make it resilient.
Maybe we will see the Mustard double Quartermaster this game if it goes long enough. Tyson's just going to collect all the pieces.
It really could.
Reporting for duty.
This is a lot of board, though, for Tyson. Like, Gaara's significantly behind.
Are you going to comment on the Shredder misplacement? Or does he play Argus? If he plays Argus, it might be...
Yeah, fair enough.
Maybe. Probably not.
It could be. Hyped, what? You also sometimes place on the outside, too.
Only if there's, like, a Vile Teacher involved. You want to place it sometimes
tokens
on the far...
Yeah, okay. Fair enough. Oh, so that's why. All right. I blame Monk for that. Monk's like, hyped, why don't you actually do that? But
I do. Yeah. Almost always.
All right.
Where is it, the Vile Teacher?
So you have to usually put your Pilot Shredder in the middle of your minions.
Yeah, but what about the Vile Teacher?
He's saying so because the token spawns to
the
right.
I think he saw what I did exactly, but I always put it in the middle. And if it's offset Vile from the middle a little bit, it's probably involving a Vile Teacher. But it's never on the outside.
Right. So you can put it to the right of the Vile Teacher.
I see.
So that way it spawns to a
bunch of 1/1s.
Oh, so the other way around.
Yeah.
That's right. Hyped,
Silver,
you are perfect.
Pulls more value on board for Tice. He's already winning that battle.
Yeah, that's the second Consecrate, but he's going for a lot of tempo now. And he's pressing in because he's got a lot of damage. Potentially lethal.
If you ever play Druid with Sky Golem, it's imperative that you put it next to the lore, though. Because Wii Spellstopper on a golden lore is the most beautiful thing in the game. If you've seen it, you've seen God, basically.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
And I'll become a believer, huh?
Did we just lose a zebra skin?
That's a lot of time.
He's got to try it again. Oh, Leopard's not bad, too. It's very 70s.
Reporting for duty.
What is that?
I need chat to give me their energy on this one.
Desert River. There we go.
Thank you, chat.
Do you want to play aggressively into Consecrate here?
Right, your opponent hasn't used any Consecrations.
No, like, what if you Equality, then Juggler? Let me and play a minion.
Into the Shredder? Do you have to, though? I feel like you can save the Equality. Although...
I wonder...
Because if you can bait out the Consecration, then you have the Quartermasters to start backing
it up. I think the play I like the most is play Juggler, Suicide the Shredder into the 5-6.
Yeah, and then kill it with True Silver.
Just get extra juggles.
Yep. Well, we can evaluate first, I guess, off of this. To the face.
That's bad.
Yeah.
Face time.
And now...
That's the second True Silver, so you don't use that.
Yeah. Well, it picks up Harrison, but is that too late?
It's pretty resilient, double-piloted guys.
Unless one of them decides to sabotage an entire mission with Doomsayer.
Yeah, is Explosive Sheep good enough? Explosive Sheep is pretty good.
Yeah, Explosive Sheep is
and Unstable
quite
Ghoul is good enough as well.
I think you actually go for some Shredder options. Because you can take back the game in a big way with Shredder options, and the other plays don't really do that. The other plays just kind of...
Oh!
Yeah, but he's got the quality, but he doesn't have enough mana.
Yeah. Can he even survive long enough?
Yeah. You can survive here. I think the Lotheb with the 5-6 and the True Silver into the Juggler means you survive
by...
No, you die.
HP.
No, you died at the... Yeah, Quartermaster on the 1-1. Double right, Quartermaster.
So you got to Consecrate here then to survive.
Yeah. But it does. You don't really see that.
Right. I mean, you know he used both True Silvers. He used both Consecrations. So he actually doesn't... It's like Coghammer to die.
He really doesn't want to use that Consecration, so he just picked up the Equality. Yeah. He's forced to.
Yeah. But you know what? It's not about, like... maybe he has an opportunity to use Kael'thas.
Okay.
Dr. Boom.
The Boomster.
Now, there is Big Game Hunter, but it's so close. Like, it's so close to death. Just boom and push.
Yeah.
Man, Dr. Boom has been kind as well.
It's a boom bot. It's like some kind of crazy stuff from the Shredder. It's the 1-1 staying alive that's going to be lethal. There's just so many options.
Everything trades so well, too.
What do you think about Juggler, KT, and when the minions respawn, you get two juggles?
I wonder.
How do you deal with Dr.
Juggle.
Boom?
Yeah, juggle an explosive sheep. It's going to, yeah.
See?
Oh, gotta believe.
Man. There's just too many death rattle minions. I guess that's an option, considering that Kael'thas can also absorb more damage.
Yeah.
Equality is definitely the safer bet, though. Is it? I don't know. Actually, this is so dangerous that you might have to just go for
some really
big
stupid
YOLO
stuff.
Yeah.
Which is exactly the point. Like, it really should have done it last turn.
Yeah, last turn was pretty... Maybe... Oh, I mean, we're saying about the hands. I don't know.
All right, let's see what comes out of the Shredder. An explosive sheep!
There it is.
What?
All you have to do is play Consec... Oh, no!
Oh. Okay, he's got to go fast. He's running out of time. Dude, he still might die to Boombot RNG. Wait! Oh, no! He can't play the Hero Power! Oh. It's over! He's over.
No, double one.
Oh, no. We forgot it kills off the Big Game Hunter, so it's like a pretty high chance.
He could have kept the Harrison alive, let the explosive sheep kill the Shredder, and he would have had the 4 HP Harrison to absorb.
Right.
But it was really, I mean, it was not down to the wire there.
Oh, man.
The rope was burning.
Yeah, you know, Gar's getting out-muscled.
Yeah, Gar can't be feeling too well now. He really, like, it through his plays, we felt that he felt confident that he would take that match.
Yeah.
And losing like that is the worst way.
He still can do this, though.
He's up against Druid, which is a fine matchup, but Paladin used to be really favored against Druid with the Humilities, but now it's a slower Paladin, but it doesn't have the Humilities, so will it get overrun?
I don't know.
And Tyson knows about the Mind Control tech, so he's not going to get Mind Control tech.
I think we're overlooking the fact that if he went a little YOLO in the turn before, he probably would have won. Like, some outstanding comeback.
Yeah, it would have been pretty nuts.
Yeah.
Really hard to make that call, though, considering that, he had to just play for survival. And as a result, it costed him.
He is playing potential for survival.
Well, right now he is. It's his last strike here. Druid versus Paladin. And if he wins this, he goes to Druid versus Druid. And that, we've seen him stomp a Moz before, because it is a slower Druid with a bunch of taunts. So perhaps he can climb back.
Did he just throw back a muster?
I didn't see. Mulligans are a little bit weird. The Zombie Chow also moved to the right. Okay. I'm guessing he...
Yeah, he kept Zombie Chow.
Kept Zombie Chow.
Is muster not very good against Druid?
I guess because swipe is too easy to punish it. Right? Hype?
I like keeping muster, and I like not being keeping swipe as druid.
Right.
But maybe he just wants to guarantee the muster quartermaster later.
Ooh, a classic misplay on turn two, not having wild growth.
Yeah.
Yeah, ooh, that was a mistake.
Tez is going to really suffer for that.
Yeah.
He really is. Look at that hand.
Well, now he plays.
Did he keep? Oh, we didn't
shade.
See his mulligan.
No, I think he tossed away everything, didn't he?
Okay.
Oh, my God. Here comes the muster top deck of Nightmare.
Oh, boy. I already feel it.
Oh, no. It'll be a muster top deck like 2 turns from now for the ultimate soul-crushing Juggle-thon.
I mean, it seems to avoid the shade for now. Mm-hmm. Oh, Innervate will help a lot. In fact, I think it really like, smoothens out everything.
I think
everything.
I like Swipe. It's the only thing you can play without Innervate, and you kind of want to keep Innervate to smooth stuff out.
Yeah.
And you can clear the board, kind of. And if he had Muster, he would have played it. So, yeah, if you might lose your Shade to a True Silver. You know, big deal. Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Yeah, it does because...
Totally behind this.
True Silver is still a little bit awkward against
Actually,
Druid.
The only other play I would have considered was to Swipe Innervate Hero Power and then move into regular Druid the Claw next turn and just to keep your Shade...
Yeah, that's a possibility as well.
Yeah, he's got the Harrison for the True Silver anyways. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the Harrison against the True Silver is really nice. And, you know, normally True Silver is really awkward against Druid, so this is a pretty good way for Tice to climb back.
Wasn't he supposed to draw that Wild Growth earlier?
Yeah, he was supposed to.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
It's too bad. Might have costed him, but it really seems to have worked out okay.
Yeah. Yeah, Tice is ahead here, and it's a match where he needs to be ahead in, so that's great. For him, not for Gera. It's actually terrible for Gera.
Yeah. Although, ultimately...
It's actually looking like Height might be the only Templestorm player to qualify.
Mm. It could be. You're right.
It's actually really looking like that right now.
Well, we'll see. The Paladin still can draw into a quality and kill the board.
Yeah, this is going to be awkward, though, this taunt. This is what he's going to do, right? Or...
The Druid of the Claw? Yeah, it counts. It just contests really well against the Pilot Shredder.
Yeah.
And then you have Ancient of Lore. Or even Scenarios, depends on how things go.
I'm so torn in these matchups. Like, I usually have, like, some guy I want to win. Mm-hmm. Just can't do it. Like, I want like, Gerd to win this game, because I like Paladin more than Druid. Mm-hmm. But, like, the only player I like to see... Druid on is Tice.
You don't like any other Druid players out
no.
there?
For me, it feels like Tice makes the only plays like I just don't imagine, and then like two turns later they work out. Mm-hmm. And Druid's a class that it's pretty easy to predict. So that just impresses me from time to time, and
gotcha.
I've casted enough of him that's you know been a consistent thing.
Nice. Not even Strifecrow? Strifecrow used to be known as a Druid player.
He doesn't play this type of Druid, though. But Strifecrow plays, like, the controlling style.
Yeah.
Even if he has double combo, he plays control. Or Thice plays, like, the very aggressive stuff. So it exactly goes back to that, where it's not, like, challenging the results or how the plays. It's... I expect Strifecrow to play exactly that way.
Sure.
Yeah.
All right, well... Tice has a couple of ways he can play this turn. He's got access to 10 mana. He just used Peacekeeper, and he couldn't deal with the Pilot Shredder anyways, so do you feel okay putting out Scenarios?
Hmm. Doesn't seem to trade that well. He just kills the transfer free.
That's true.
It softens him up for Swipe, though.
It does, in fact, and Swipe Druid the Claw is something next turn you could follow.
Oh, yeah, that's a Jake Swipe now.
Spell Power Swipe.
Oh, man.
That is troublesome.
That's the juice.
Well, Tyrion Forgering comes into hand.
He can come into play. That coin's been saved just for him.
Yeah, I mean,
great.
What are you going to save coin for at this stage?
You're not even that sad if it gets silenced.
The main thing would be like a crazier muster combo.
Like two musters and quartermaster.
Other than that, you're really just pushing for an extra dude on some turn. I mean, Tyrion's going to work. It's just, if you're Gera, it just doesn't look like it would.
And if a 2-health minion or less pops out of that Shredder, you can make basically pave the way for Tyrion to be highly effective. There's nothing going to be much on board. He would have to specifically have silence and a lot of removal.
Tyrion time.
Guard really
swipe.
Doesn't mind leaving Death Rattle minions up. Specifically the one that's been targeted by Alder Peacekeeper. Alright, so. Now that Tyrion's out and you don't have a keeper.
Tyrion can pick up a Kobold or a Thalnos for the 6-3 swipe.
Whoa. Spell power off the 2-drop.
The weapon is pretty troublesome.
How much mana is that mini mage as well?
4. So you can get that off Sky Golem. It is pretty sick, actually.
Okay. Yeah. He could also Azure or Wrath into the other Innervate, allowing him to clear. Because he'd Innervate again on the Wrath for 2.
Right. Or I guess if he's going to be doing
or Bluegill.
That, he can Drake into the Keeper.
Bluegill Torpedo.
Yeah? Is that what it's called?
That's what I used to call him. But Bluegill's been a lot less impressive since GVG. Because as it turns out, the creature that he kills spawns another creature most of the time.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Recombobulator, reasonable stats coming out of the Pilot Shredder. And now Tice is in a little bit of an awkward situation here. He's going to Wrath Innervate
Swipe. Really wants
swipe.
That sounds.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I don't actually see the draw. I just see a bunch of cards on the screen.
I mean, he's got the combo as well, so I like this.
Oh, he wrath for full. I see.
Yeah, because he has the innervate, the Savage Roar and the Force of Nature. Mm-hmm. So he just wants to put minions onto the board. Now,
I see.
If he heals up, he's out of range, so it won't be good enough.
He is out of range. Yes, there's no one draw that does it.
And it contests well, reasonably, with everything else. That 5/6 body is really decent against Druid. Except Drew the Claw.
Yeah, well, and these 2/5 attack, the weapon and the Guardian of Price is going to go straight into
the chance. I really just like Cenarius.
Yeah, for sure. Now Gar needs the Mind Control tech.
Oh, he's
or the Consecrate, okay.
Where
charge.
This is less vulnerable, but it's also a bit less effective.
Says it for combo better. Oh my.
That's good.
That's just another taunt. So, how do you sequence this best? Instead of 2 taunt minions, basically build a stronger Sunwalker.
I think you weapon into the 3/2, then you Cog Hammer to kill the 4/4.
Yeah.
And then you Belcher.
That looks good. Yeah.
Seems really high value.
Looks like he sees it.
And he still should be safe from combo, right?
Yeah. He has to deal with the Cenarius, though, so. I guess the Cog Hammer helps.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know, Lay on Hands is really clutch, too. In fact, Sylvanas. In fact, if, like, Druid can't really press too much, there might be a chance where Paladin can keep picking up cards to stabilize.
Like, both those minions are so good against Shredder. Man, you know what I was looking for there? Lorewalker Cho. Yeah. That would have made it really interesting.
Yeah, because then, you know, Druid's cards, they're only playing it to kill. Paladin would be playing it to come back on board. Defender of Argus. So, there's a couple ways you can play this out. Do you want to acknowledge Sylvanas now?
I wonder.
Just let it pick up a 1 health or 2 health minion.
I think I like Dude, Argus, the Ooze, and the Dude.
I guess he feels like this is his only chance to really play Lay on Hands. Like, it gets increasingly more difficult.
Yeah, that's for sure. That's really something to consider. Mm. And if you play Lay on Hands, you essentially play around Sylvanas because you don't build the board.
Right.
So while it's kind of bad, just it fits on both ends, or otherwise it may not at all.
So I guess just kill off the 2/3 and then hit.
Yeah.
Might as well get working on that Cog Hammer to the face. You have so many charges.
You could just hit the Sylvanas here first, actually. Because if he takes your 5, then 1, you could just sack it with the little ooze.
Right. All right, so, man, it looks like Gaara
absorbs 6 of 14, 8 plus 7 is 5 off lethal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, 4 off lethal because he has... No, the enemy wouldn't matter because you have to hero power down the 1/2. Yeah, 5 off lethal. I think that's quite good considering you can Ancient Allure the turn after and then innervate whatever you get. Or would you rather innervate whatever you get this turn? I think I like pushing for combo.
Yeah, you still keep the Sylvanas on the board, so it's not like you're giving up the board.
Sylvanas takes zero damage.
Yeah.
So you're trading now. And it takes the 1-2, so the taunt's out of the way.
I guess this means you want Ancient Allura now. Cenarius?
Cenarius puts the most bodies out for the combo.
Cenarius pushes for an extra 7, which does push it into lethal.
I think he is afraid of the Mind Control
Man,
deck.
He can innervate Lothab. That's so big!
That's huge.
Now he shuts down his opponent to opportunity to do like an equality clear easily. Yep.
His real only hope is taunting up Sylvanas.
I have no time. If his opponent has Keeper of the Grove,
which he does. But he can't play it with combo.
So, Emperor gets drawn.
Oh my.
Wow, Silence an Emperor.
Yeah. I think it'd be Gar's crazy enough to make those plays.
Right.
Silence Emperor is just insane.
Yeah. It's so hard for Paladin to dodge combo at this stage, and then the Emperor just makes it so much easier for Tice.
Yeah, you know, Gaara's hand is just a little bit too slow. Gildazon never gets time to set up.
It's not just that. Like, just the 5 face damage puts him in range by itself.
It's true. He could heal out of it, but he can't deal with
the board. He's forced a True Silver out of it.
Yeah.
How sad is that?
It's pretty sad, man. And that's assuming he can even stay out of his opponent having like a board where he can like double Savage Roar as well. I mean, because everything's cheaper now.
Yeah. Everything is cheaper, but still useless, unfortunately, on Gaara's side.
Yeah, a little too late on his
Emperor. That's going to be it. There's absolutely no way.
Tice stays alive. He's going to 3-1 Gaara.
It's going to take a while, though. I think Gaara's going to make a play roughly 90 seconds from now. We can talk about that. Like, what is the absolute safest play here?
Well, you have to kill off the Emperor. Let me
think. I think it has to be KT. You just die?
Yeah.
No, you're technically 1 damage off dying with the KT play. If that means anything at all.
Yep. And he's going to be covered plenty. As there's so many ways to kill. Tice is going to advance 3-1, and Gaara is not able to win these control scenarios here because his...
Yeah, there's just not much he could have done. Yeah,
Dex just can't compete with that kind of speed.
Yeah.
Tempo, so well done by Tice. He stays alive, and looks like he immediately goes over the handshake. Really good sportsmanship. Well, Hyped, your teammate's out.
Is he not your teammate, too?
He is.
Whoa.
But...
Tempo Store Drama?
Oh, yes. Absolutely. You know, but at the same time, you know, he did definitely take a really different approach to everybody. Yeah. In fact, all the Tempo Storm players brought really different strategies to the tournament. And it seems like, you know, the Nylon players stand more united. So it's interesting to see how that works out. Tice, you're going to join us for the couch.
Yeah, make sure that mic is really close.
People yep, okay. Okay.
Whoa. Nailed it. First one.
Yeah, I'm still a bit confused about how the games go. I felt like it wasn't made for Gaara, this game. I had that feeling a bit, like, especially in the Mech Mage, I was there really lucky. And,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
That was like 3 or 4 top decks with 3 or 4 excellent RNG results.
Yeah, it started with the Shredder, what was really painful. I had a really good start, but he stole the Shredder. Yeah. Well, I felt really sad about it, but yeah, after that, I really drew the cards that I needed to still win the game there.
It was actually because he was holding mini bots at the time. If he stole your Mech Warper, it wasn't really that bad either. It just would have really sucked if he got the Snow Chugger. That was about it. If he got the Snow Chugger, I think he would have just leveled him. But you did anyway, so I mean,
yeah,
in more spectacular fashion.
Yeah, pretty well done. You know, were you worried at all? Because you got 0-3 by Ignite, and we were... You know, thinking that you were coming in as the favorite to maybe advance in this group in first place, and now you come in here, you're losing 4 games in a row. Was there any kind of a?
Yeah, I felt actually a bit worried, and especially Gaara had a pretty okay lineup against me, and when the priest was already out after the first game, I felt pretty worried. Yeah, but Yeah. I still had the with the decks that I still had left. I felt that I could get this paladin if it was a bit with me that I called just 3-0 as paladin. So, but yeah, his druid deck was also pretty scary. So I was really happy that my mage went out. That was really important for me. Yeah,
well, sure. You still have an opponent ahead of you to qualify to the round of 16. You still have to beat Amaz. How do you feel that's going to work?
I feel pretty good against Amaz. I think my lineup is pretty okay against him. Yeah, I played him already a lot of times before, and yeah, I'm excited to play against him again.
Really? Because he said the opposite. He said he's bored of playing you. Did you hear that? He called you out, man.
That's maybe because it's that's maybe because he lost the last time. I don't know.
Oh. Ooh. What happened the time before that? Like, what's the overall series score? Or have you ever lost?
The last time we met was in at Fire Game. It was the last time.
Gotcha. But overall record against the Maz, what is it?
It is funny that you asked, because we were just looking in the morning, and yeah, I have a 3-0 over him now.
Oh, so, you've never lost to Amaz?
Not yet.
Wow.
Oh, man.
Well, I guess he's got to pick it up, man.
Get those Gosu bets going.
Get those Gosu bets going. That's right. Get that dust on that website. Get those Gosu gamer points.
Yeah.
And, congrats, Dice. You won.
Congratulations.
Good luck in the next round.
Yeah, we'll be seeing the next round pretty soon. We'll get to see if Dice still reigns dominance over Amaz.
It's pretty cool, man, that he's undefeated against him, in my opinion.
Or not.
Or not.
We'll see when we come back.
It is.
We'll be back in just a few minutes, guys.